one important topic related to try and catch block. Okay, see, I'll remove this. This is the block which is available. This is for sure you are getting exception in this particular code. Now here I'll specify try main exception. Now if I run this program, what will be the output? Main exception will be the output. Clear? Okay, I will comment this. Which type of exception we are expecting here? Array index out of bounds exception. Okay, if I specify it like this, it handles and it displays array index out of bounds exception. Happy. Now if I enable this code, what will be the output? Even that main exception is able to handle the exception, even this subclass will be handling the exception. Accurate matching is this one. This is global, it will match to any kind of exception, that we know. So which one you prefer, that control will go there and it will display the output, either first or second? If I enable, it will go to second one. Sure?
First one.
Okay, save. It is throwing an error. Okay, whenever you are providing multiple catch blocks, make sure that subclasses catch blocks will be first and base class exception catch block will be next. Now if I specify in this fashion, first control will check this particular catch blocks. If it is matching, it will enter into this. If none of the first catch blocks are matching, then it will go to last catch block. Anyway, that is super class, it will match. Got it, right? Anyway, it will not go to this position because here accurate matching exception handler is there. It will handle and displays arithmetically. Clear? Any doubts so far? Make a note. Whenever multiple catch blocks are there, first subclasses, then only super class is preferred. That's it.